Hello, in this video I'm going to show you my new Open MIDI Stomper, which is an open source MIDI pedal board. It has 8 stomp buttons with 8 LEDs, 2 expression pedals inputs, and it works with the Arduino Pro Micro, so it's USB MIDI class compliant. And it was built inside this nice Hammond aluminum enclosure, so it's built to last. I made this pedal for you to use it like this, but you can also use it as a template to build different kinds of MIDI pedal boards, which I'm going to show you later how to do it. And it's super flexible because it has 8 buttons, but also it has 8 banks, so you can change between banks, and each bank can have, let's say, 8 buttons, so 8 times 8, 64 buttons in total. But there's also more, each button can send more than one message at the same time, and we can edit this message in a web browser editor. If you're a guitar player like me, or if you need a MIDI pedal board for anything else, I'm sure you're going to love this project. So already click on that subscribe button, and let's see how I did it. Okay, so how can we use the pedal? First, we need to program it. So come to the GitHub repository, I have the link here below, and you will have this page here. Here you will have all the files you need and the explanation for the code, for the circuit. Everything you need is here. So first come here and download zip or clone with your GitHub. Also, something really important is this wiki. Here we have detailed explanations about how to use it, but we're gonna see that later. You're going to download this folder with code, files for the enclosure, presets, schematic, etc. So first here, let's take a look in the schematic. There's something I did here for the first time, which is using a button matrix. So the Arduino Pro Micro, which is the Arduino I am using in this project, doesn't have enough pins for 8 LEDs, 8 buttons, and 2 analog inputs for expression pedals. I am missing 2 pins here. So I used a technique called button matrix, which I'm not going to enter into details, but what you're going to do is that we are going to connect 1 pin of each button to each other like this. Take a look in the purple wire, okay, in a row, and this row is going to go to a pin, and the same thing with the other buttons, with the other row. And then we're gonna connect the columns with the other pin. So one column to a pin, another column to another pin, another column and another column. So we are wiring these buttons in columns and rows. And that's how we wire a matrix, okay? And the LEDs, each LED is connected to a digital pin through a 220 ohms resistor. You can connect a higher value resistor for less brightness, but this is the minimum you need to use in order to not fry your LEDs. And these two here are 1/4-inch audio jacks, and you wire this way so you can connect them to an expression pedal. And we're gonna wire them like we were wiring a potentiometer. Also, we have here the enclosure file, which is a template that you can just put on top of your enclosure if you're using the same as mine and just drill the holes at the right places. That was exactly what I did. Okay, so let's take a look here at the code. We have this folder and this folder. So this folder here is the editor, which I'm going to show you later, so you don't need to change anything here, but in case you want to see it, how it was done, it is here. But the actual code is this folder. So you are going to open this file here. There are some libraries you need to install, like the USB rename, which allows you to give a name to your MIDI controller, to your Arduino, which here I chose Open MIDI Stomper. There are also other libraries like the MIDI USB and the responsive analog read. If you don't know how to install a library or the basics of the IDE or anything like that, please check here my DIY MIDI controller workshop. It's a free course where I'm going to teach you all the basics so you can build your first MIDI controller with buttons and potentiometers, and you don't even need the Arduino. I'm going to show you how you can use a simulator. So if you don't know the basics, please go there and come back here, okay? But anyways, you're gonna have to install the libraries. So I made this controller so it can be used as a template for you to build different types of MIDI pedals. And for example, remember here in our schematic that we are wiring in columns and rows. So here you can type the number of rows and the number of columns, okay? And here the pins of the rows, the pins of the columns, and also the pins of the LEDs. And remembering, we have the instructions here in more details here in our wiki. Okay, so you're going to upload the code. Since I already uploaded, I'm going to show you how it actually works. So here in my MIDI monitor, you can see that, for example, if I press a button, I'm getting message, for example, from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 in MIDI channel 1. So here I can send up to 8 different messages. But what I did here is that if I press and hold for 1 second one button, for example here, you can see that now this LED is on, which means that we are in this bank. So we have 8 banks of 8 buttons. So we have up to 64 buttons. However, there is more, but I'm going to show you later. See now that we are in channel 6 now. And if I come here, we are in channel 5. So you can map those buttons to different messages. But we can make even more. Instead of sending just one message and see that the message is sent when we release the button. That's because when I coded, I found that for me to have this kind of hold thing was better to send the notes when I release them instead of when I press it. So coming back to the code here, we have this tab called MIDI messages. Here is where you can actually change which kind of message and which number, which value you can send. And you can send up to 5 messages per button. But see how crazy it is to edit the code here. That's why I created the Open MIDI Stomper editor. So we can actually edit the MIDI messages in the browser in the easiest way possible. For example, so let's say we want to change bank 1, and here you choose which button you want to edit. So let's edit button 1. And in button 1, you have up to 5 messages you can send. So with each button, you can send up to 5 messages. So the way it's set up in the beginning is just sending 1 message per button, but we can send more. So here, first you choose the type, note number, control change, program change, or toggle. Toggle will send a note number, but it will change on or off every time that you press the button. Let's say you press 1, it's on, you press again, it's off. So let's send a note number, number 0, and you can also choose the channel. And here you can, let's say, send a control change and send control change 1, channel 0, and channel 0 in the Arduino Pro Micro is the same as channel 1. So we always start with 0. And then we can send, let's say, a note number 10 in channel 1. Okay, that's it for button 1. And if you put a minus 1, this means that you won't send the message here. So if you just want to send, for example, 3 messages, you just configure the 3 messages and the other ones you just leave as minus 1, okay? So that's button 1. So, okay, button 2, let's just send another control change, but now control change 2 and program change 4. Okay, so let's just configure button 1 and 2. But now I want to configure my bank 2. Let's just configure 1 button so we don't waste that much time. So I want to send here button 36 and control change 20 in channel 10. You can use channel from 0 to 15, okay? 16 channels. Now that we configured, we can just click here, copy configuration to clipboard. Okay, now come back to the code. And we are just going to select everything here inside the curly braces, I never know. Delete and copy what we just did. Command T organizes your code. Okay, so now if we upload, let's take a look here in the MIDI monitor. So first message, see now that I am sending message 1 and then control change 1 and also note 2. So let's just take a look if it is what we did. Yes. And if we go to bank 2, which is the other one we edit, we can see that now we are sending note 36 and control in channel 2 and control change 20 in channel 11, which is exactly what we did here in our editor. So it's really easy to edit every note from every button in every bank using this editor, okay? And what I want you to do in exchange is to create your presets and share with the community. Because I know there's many pedals, many different plugins that require different configurations, and that's what I want from you, that you create your preset of your bank and share with the community. So how can we do that? Let's say I created this bank here. I edit this bank. I can come here and export bank configuration. This will export a TXT file, a text file, okay? And here in the wiki, there's instructions so how you can upload your presets. With time, I'm going to put all the presets you make here in the presets folder. For example, this is the basic configuration, which means that you're sending just notes 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. Okay, if now we want to import a preset in our bank, we can come here, for example, bank 8. See that this is the factory default. So let's import whatever bank we have. See now that the message changed. And again, just copy to clipboard, go to the sketch, paste what we have, upload the code. So if we come to our bank 8, we should have those messages we just edited. So everything is working perfectly. So there you have the Open MIDI Stomper, which is super flexible. You can edit presets, import, export presets using a browse editor, and you can use this as a template to build different kinds of MIDI controllers. How cool is that? So I hope you liked it, and I hope you can contribute to the project, adding your own presets, or even contributing with the code. So help sharing this project with your friends, with your community, so a lot of people can have access to an affordable DIY open source MIDI pedal, the Open MIDI Stomper. And if you'd like to build your own MIDI controllers like this or like anything else with encoders, with lots of potentiometers, buttons, displays, motorized faders, Bluetooth controllers, you name it, please check my courses here below in the Nerd Musician Pro website. The Nerd Musician Pro is a 3-course bundle that includes the Making Music with Arduino, where I teach you how to use my templates to build any kind of MIDI controller, the Arduino programming, which I actually teach you how to code, and the KiCad PCB design, where I'll teach you how to build your own printed circuit boards. You can buy each course separately, or you can buy the bundle at a cheaper price. And you can find everything there in the Nerd Musician Pro website. So now I want you to let me know which kind of project do you want me to build next. Tell me here in the comments, okay? So see you in the next video. Ciao.